In this particular video today, I'm going to show you how to remove that glow that is usually on the background, how to make your background more even. Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy, Ntege, again with yet another amazing video. When you look at this particular image here, the background, of course, it was a PVC print, and the PVC print was a bit glowing. And since we are shooting in a very small space, and we did not have any of those honeycombs that they put on the light to avoid light hitting, spilling onto the background, we had a challenge of this particular glow on the background. So we had to find a way of removing this particular background so that we create a little bit of more depth to make this thing a bit more infinite, more pale, more matte-like. Because when you look at the whole piece, it was printed on matte, but for some reason, the softbox illuminated light onto the whole background, and this glow, in my opinion, looks very ugly. So what we did, we did a shot. When we realized that we had this problem, we did a shoot of this particular of the background alone, because we knew in post-production we would superimpose it in the background without us, of course, necessarily having to cut out the whole image. Okay, and if you want to see how I edit all these full pictures, you should enroll into the Retouching Secrets Masterclass. You're going to find all this particular work being demonstrated, how I edit all these pictures, from the hair, from the makeup, how do I edit the lipstick, how do I do the skin tones, how do I blend all this stuff, how do I give her body shape, and how do I edit all the ground and all that stuff. Check out the Retouching Secrets Masterclass by clicking the first link in the description below. So what are we going to do? We're going to come here and duplicate this layer, and we're going to rename this Background Replacement. Yes, I'm calling it Background Replacement, but we're not going to cut it basically. So we're going to just come here, select, you look for Subject. So Photoshop, from Photoshop CC21, it's going to give you these options of how you can even select the subject. So what are we going to do now? We're just going to come after selecting the subject. Of course, the selection doesn't have to be that accurate. I'm just going to come here and say, and create a layer mask just right next to it by clicking next. So the next thing we are going to do, we're just going to come here and get our background, the one that we shot. This is the background that we shot here, and then drop it right on top here, just like that. And I'm going to come and press enter, you know. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to come and reduce the opacity of this, and then just come and increase the background. So it's not going to be really a perfect alignment, because we kept on moving the candles and the light, but the reflection we want to remove is just the upper part of the reflection. So I'm just going to try to align. Not really, it doesn't have to be accurate, because the background itself is not that accurate. So I just have to blend these particular pieces there and then. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to come here and bring back the opacity of this to 100. So I'm just going to come and press Command or Control on my keyboard, and then click onto this, onto the layer mask, just like that. When I click onto the layer mask, the selection comes back. So I'll come onto this and then right click here and select inverse. Once I select inverse, I'm just going to create a layer mask just right next to this particular layer, like that. See how it comes back on top? So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to come and begin refining this particular layer mask. You know, I don't want it to have all these, that particular edge that looks like a razor blade. No, I hate this edge. Now this is the challenge we have. The fur coat looks all trimmed out. So here we come and just get our brush tool, and then we shall leave it in normal here. And then we just come, keep the flow at around 40, 40 is good enough. And then we are just going to get our black paint and just paint over to bring back the edges that were lost in there during the selection, just like that. Because remember, the goal is not to remove, you know, to remove the actual background, but it's just to blend this particular background to the rest of the thing, to the rest of the image. So I just come, I actually just get even, I'll reduce the opacity here and just, you know, just slightly burn it over the edges. I just rather paint over the edges so that I get these edges blend into the whole background, just like that. You know, the goal is not to trim out the whole background, so I'll even just push it far away. So for the ground, I don't want to really blend a lot. I'll just leave the ground the way it was, the flow here, so that I get the effect more. So for this, I just come and keep it the way it is. But the goal was only to get back, to remove that particular glow from, you know? So let's look at the before and after. Look at this. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after. Before and after. Basically, what we've done, we have covered the glow with a background that we had taken, you know, back, that we had taken without any kind of lighting. Now we have the whole image having that kind of blended kind of light. At least it looks like more of now a fine art piece than it looked like. The other one, it was overly too washed out, and we didn't want that particular wash. We still wanted that particular feel, that particular matte feel. So there you have it. That is how you remove glows or glow reflections from the background.